our forces. And he was a warrior, a general, seen everything in war. And he felt that the hand of God was on this nation, guiding it forth. And Lincoln thought the same. And each time when we had a great crisis and a great danger to this little bark of a nation, this experiment in freedom, some miraculous aspect has taken place. It seems to me, in terms of leadership. We had it with Lincoln. We had it with Roosevelt. I believe we had it again with Reagan. And now, if you looked around, and if I became back in my own corner of the world, I'm going to be a casting director casting the President of the United States. Well, let me look at the field.
Mm-hmm. Right? Yeah.
And I say, well, wait a minute. Look at this fellow. Look at this fellow. He came from a legacy of heroes, which continues to this day, because John McCain has two boys. One's going to Iraq, one's been in Iraq. He was captured and almost tortured to death and held on to survive 5 years of torture and give the men around him the ability to survive. Bud Day, I know a little bit about it, look this up. Bud Day, you probably know many of these things, but I'm just putting it on you. Bud Day chose John McCain to be his chaplain. He was the superior officer, the ranking officer. And he chose, and John said, no, I'm not, you know, it's not for me. I don't think I can do that. And he said, no, you're my chaplain. And the reason why I said it was because he found something in John that must be transferred to these guys. And his first sermon, he said, as Christ said, give unto God, give unto Caesar that which is Caesar's, and give unto God that which is God's. And he said, do not pray for God to release you from this prison. Caesar is keeping us imprisoned, and Caesar is going to have to release us. Pray to God for the strength to behave properly as soldiers of the United States. And he survived. He survived that prison camp, and he helped others survive that prison camp. One other little story, there's another little story, and again, you may know these stories, but they're deeply moving to me. The story of this one man, one soldier, who got something from home in terms of needles and threads for knitting, and he knitted an American flag. And every day, at noontime, when they would have soup and they would be gathered, he would put the shirt with the American flag up on a little chair, and they would all say the Pledge of Allegiance. And this flag was discovered by the prison guards, and they took this young man out and beat him almost to death. And they threw him back in the cell, and these guys surrounded him and tried to bring him back and revive him and do whatever they could with their bandages made of their own clothing. And John recounted that at the end of the day, and there was a light in the room right in the center, he could, you know, couldn't sleep in the dark, there was none of this, but he saw, before he went to sleep, he saw this young man with his eyes beaten shut almost, trying to see in the light to create another American flag. Now, I'll tell you guys, these people humble me. I am proud to be with you. You guys are heroes to me, every one of you. And you guys are heroes to me. And there's a greatness, and this greatness in part, and maybe great part, and came from being citizens of the United States. I have a great belief in our country. We can do anything. We are a beacon of light to the world. All of this nonsense about the world, that we're doing something wrong,
that's right,
is, I must tell you, it's a bit of baloney. As I said, you know, human beings, we're all learning lessons here. There's nobody better or different, and there's nobody perfect. And in a democracy, when all of us imperfect beings have a voice and can say anything that we want to and do anything we want to, it seems like an almost insanity that we're going to burst apart from all this freedom. But somehow God believed that we could handle it. That's what I think. God said, I think we can give it to him now. Gave him the Ten Commandments. They screwed that up a little bit. It's still around. They only broke one of the tablets. But it's still around. It's still holding together. And this nation wants to found itself on what remains of the Ten Commandments. Let's give them a chance.
Yeah.
Anyway, I think that, you know, I'm convinced that John McCain has very special angels guiding him. And some of them are in physical form with guys like Bud Day. And I think that he's picked this marvelous person to be his vice president.
Yay!
And I have to say, I went last night, and of course, and that was a moment. I'm going to remember these moments. Sometimes you know that something important is happening on a moment. When that woman walked out of that corridor and onto the stage for her first moment of us all seeing her, it was astounding. She was so poised, so strong. She introduced her family with so much love and pride and never took a pause. Yeah. Walked right to the podium and spoke these very clear words. She was beautiful. I was deeply moved. And of course it was like a shot in the, heard around the world when he announced it. Nobody saw this coming. Well, and nobody leaked it either.
Yeah.
You know, all of a sudden, she was upon us. Magnificent.
Yeah.
Magnificent. So anyway, there's, if you're, sometimes you're given the vision to see the truth, sometimes you can see history being made as you see it.
Yeah.
In our own lives, all of us, we know there were moments in our lives that changed our lives.
Yeah.
We can see it. That was the course. Then we met this person. Then that happened. Then I made this terrible mistake. I'm talking about myself here. This terrible mistake. Then it took me all these years to wake up to it. Then I paid my dues for it. Then I came to this. And then this happened. And now I'm a conservative. Period of the United States, it means that I'm an American.
Yeah.
And we've got to hope that we can bring people together. That's why McCain is such a gift to us, because no one can question his authority, his character, and his ability continuously to reach out to people to bring them together. He's done it. He will continue to do it. He's got, even in his own community of Republican Party, you know, they don't know where he's going to take them.
Yeah.
But he took them to Sarah Palin.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Anyway, so there's something brewing in this history. It's a great story being told here, and we're all on the front row of it, even on the front lines of it. So I'm proud.